Thank you. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. All time belongs to him and all the ages. To him be glory and power through every age, forever. Amen. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ our Lord guard us and keep us. Amen. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and our minds.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, nor with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death hath no more dominion over him. For in that he died unto sin once, but in that he liveth, unto God. Likewise reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ is risen from the dead, and become the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Welcome to our Easter service. We are so happy that you are here with us celebrating the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are sharing this worship together, St. Ninian, St. John the Divine, and St. Peter's, and it has been a real blessing all of this Holy Week to share in the services together. We also want to welcome Bendale and Rockcliffe, our nearby nursing homes, and we pray that this Easter season brings them special blessings after such a difficult journey through COVID. We hope this worship brings you comfort and that you are able to gather, at least virtually, with some of your friends and family at this important time of year. The land that we are standing on today is the traditional territory of many nations, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat peoples, and is now home to many diverse First Nations, Inuit, and Métis peoples. We acknowledge that Toronto is covered by Treaty 13, signed with the Mississaugas of the Credit, and the Williams Treaties, signed with multiple Mississaugas and Chippewa bands.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Almighty God,
to you our hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father. Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Lord of life and power, through the mighty resurrection of your Son, you have overcome the old order of sin and death and have made all things new in him. May we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, reign with him in glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit is alive, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is written in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, beginning at the 34th verse. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear. Not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him. That everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, because his mercy endureth forever. Let Israel now confess that he is gracious, and that his mercy endureth forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and has become my salvation. The voice of joy and health is in the dwellings of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord bringeth mighty things to pass. The right hand of the Lord is exalted.
thank thee, for thou hast heard me, and hath become my salvation. The same stone which the builders refused is become the headstone in the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The second reading is written in Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 15, verses 1 to 11. Now I should remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, and then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to someone untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace towards me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And conquering Son, endless is the victory thou o'er death hast won. Angels in bright raiment rolled the stone away, kept the folded grave close where thy body lay. And conquering Son, endless is the victory thou o'er death hast won. Lord Jesus meets us, risen from the tomb. Lovingly he greets us,
of triumph sing, for her Lord now liveth, death has lost its sting. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son, endless is the victory thou o'er death has won. No more we doubt thee, glorious Prince of life. Life is not without thee, in us in our strife. Make us more than conquerors through thy deathless love. Bring us safe through Jordan to thy home above. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son, endless is the
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side. And they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place where they laid him. But go tell the disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. In the lectionary, the 50 days of Easter are characterized by the reading of the book of Acts rather than hearing from the Hebrew scriptures. We are reminded that Easter is more than one day. In the book of Acts, we hear the recounting of the people's journey post-resurrection to become the body of Christ. Said simply, this is the time before Pentecost to truly and deeply learn what it means to be the church. The disciples and followers do not have instant understanding with the realization that Jesus has risen. In today's reading from Acts, we hear a different voice from Peter in chapter 10 than we did earlier. Initially, Peter argued that all new converts to Christ should be circumcised. Today, we have heard a different message from Peter. He says, I truly understand that God shows no partiality. The peace that Peter refers to in the preaching of Jesus is a word that denotes the coming together of different ethnic groups. No one can be excluded. That is the primary Easter testimony. This is not a message of individual salvation or our own personal cleansing, but rather a testimony to God's faithfulness, intended to include all people, no exclusions. So what changed Peter's mind and conviction? Like many in Scripture, Joseph, Isaiah, Rahab, Ezekiel, Esther, Paul, Mary, to mention but a few, Peter had a dream. In the dream, God proclaimed that all people belong together. And Peter realized that he should not hinder God's intention. And neither should we. Proclaiming Jesus as Lord obligates us to the same mission that Peter is espousing. No one can be excluded if we proclaim Jesus as Lord. Learning to be the kind of church that is God's dream requires much from us. Whether three congregations or one, our calling is the same. To be the church stretches way beyond managing buildings. This is the day that God has made. And the dream we are committed to live out also belongs to God. I served on the Council of General Synod when I was in the Diocese of Qu'Appelle in southern Saskatchewan. During my tenure, we were grappling with the profound damage experienced through residential school abuse. Our diocese had a residential school, and I personally listened to horrific and painful stories. The Synod was trying to find ways to establish opportunities for healing and reconciliation. Although some were distracted by the loss of money and property, more were trying to draw the circle wide and embrace understanding and inclusion. After flying to Toronto for the meeting in Mississauga, I fell asleep. And I had a dream. In the dream, I was in a procession of many people going to a wedding banquet. Behind the cart was a procession of children and youth carrying lit candles. Every color and ethnicity joined in the procession to the banquet, and there was such joy. I am drawn aside by an Indigenous person and brought to look at a church building among some trees. He pulled out a lasso and directed the rope at the building. The lasso formed a great circle around the building and the trees. And the person looked at me, smiled, and laughed. It was miraculous that a rope could make a circle so perfectly around the building and the trees. Dreams from God come to us all to believe more greatly than we can. If it can be dreamt, such exceptional inclusion of all can be a reality. When we turn from Peter's dream to the gospel, we are met with desolation, darkness, and despair. Jesus' resurrection in Mark has a much more somber tone than the other gospels. This is not the great proclamation, "He is alive," we hear in those gospels. Instead, we are reminded how Jesus' closest friends abandoned him. The women say nothing in this account as they come to anoint the body. The voice they hear says that the promises made will be fulfilled and to go and tell the others. Instead, they all run away with fear and do not say a word. And that is the real ending of the Gospel of Mark. Hardly the great alleluia we might anticipate. Why do we continue to experience the doom and gloom of Good Friday? Later writers struggled with that and added another ending to Mark's gospel because they could not accept the ending of fear rather than the acknowledged sighting of the risen Lord. I actually think Mark has it right, and he is capturing the real feeling of the first Easter. He is writing in the first century, the earliest of the Gospels. Those who followed Christ were not accepted and were considered enemies to be persecuted. It wasn't until the second century that Christians were accepted as legal. Such intense fear after Jesus' death at the resurrection is completely understandable. Both Paul and Peter and many others were crucified themselves, a death signifying them as political insurrectionists. That first Easter started with fear and despair. It is God and God's faithfulness alone that will ever complete the story. And that is Mark's point. Mark recognized that the root of redemption and hope for the future does not rest with the disciples' ability to proclaim the risen Lord. God has made this day, not because we washed each other's feet, or ate a last meal, or prayed at the foot of the cross, or noticed an empty tomb. Changing colors from penitential purple to sacrificial red to the dark of black and then to the festive colors against a white altar is not an artificial story about personal triumph. What we see before us this Easter is, as the psalmist proclaims, "This is the day the Lord has made." COVID isn't over. We are not amalgamated. There continues to be fear, poverty, unemployment, and homelessness. There are still many dark places in our world, and maybe too in our own hearts. Reflecting Paul in the letter to the Corinthians, "By the grace of God, I am what I am." By the grace of God, we are what we are. The good news in all of our scriptures is not the eradication of fear, despair, and darkness, but rather that in the midst of all that, God is present and acting to realize God's dream that indicates the acceptance and includes all people, includes all the creation. If our mission in Scarborough cannot recognize such a radical inclusion and embrace it, if we let our fear keep us silent. God will still speak to the future and to God's dream. Instead, let us be part of that. Let us embrace the great Alleluia, that despite our many sins and weakness, God has made this day. We join in a hopeful journey, even in the midst of our trepidation. Alleluia, God's future is eternal. Alleluia, God's peace includes all. Alleluia, we all are chosen. Alleluia, we are all graced by God. The Easter Church is a daring, grace-filled congregation, willing to embrace all and build peace with all. By not skipping over our fears and despair, we can break the silence and find our voices to proclaim the great Alleluia. Alleluia, the Lord is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us join as we renew our baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. he suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, and in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of Jesus Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive to safeguard the integrity of God's creation and respect, sustain, and renew the life of the earth?
I will, with God's help.
In joy and hope, let us pray to the source of all life, saying, "Hear us, Lord of glory." For the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church throughout the world, we pray today for, from the Anglican Communion cycle of prayer, we pray today for the peace of Jerusalem. In the Anglican Church of Canada, we pray today for the Most Reverend Anne Durmond, Metropolitan, and the people and clergy of the Ecclesiastical Province of Ontario. In the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Canada, we pray today for the Dean, Council, and congregations of the Manitoba East area of the Manitoba Northwestern Ontario Synod. For the mission of the Church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray today for our bishops, for all the clergy and people. Especially today we pray for Linda, our primate, Andrew, our diocesan bishop, Kevin, our area bishop, Mark, our Indigenous bishop, the Reverend Greg, our regional dean of Scarborough, our clergy, the Reverend Helena and the Reverend Lee, and our ministry staff at our three locations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
We pray today for our parish families, Victor, Beverly, Amelita, Annalisa, Gabrielle, Vic Roy, Linda, and Emmett, the Reverend Lee and Pauline, Jean, Tobias and Beatrice, Crystal and Marcus, Michelle and Kevin, Diane, Lloyd and Dory, Ramani and Anita. This week we celebrate the birthdays of Paul, Belinda, Lois, and Bernice. May God bless you on your birthday and always, and happy birthday to you. That our risen Savior may fill us with the joy of his holy and life-giving resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That isolated and persecuted churches may find fresh strength in the Easter gospel. In our outreach and advocacy prayer cycle, we pray today for St. Barnabas Chester, its participation in the Chew on This initiative, prayer shawl ministry, support of Kennedy House Youth Center, provision of space for new and emerging musicians, its support of local artists through hosting the Riverdale Art Show, and refugee sponsorship. For St. Bartholomew, its breakfast and after-school programs, food bank, and refugee sponsorship. And for St. Bede, its support of the Bluffs Food Bank, Christmas outreach programs, and education and advocacy initiatives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may grant us humility to be subject to one another in Christian love, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may provide for those who lack food, work, or shelter, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That by his power, wars and famine may cease throughout the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may reveal the light of his presence to the sick, the weak, and the dying, that they may be comforted and strengthened. We pray today for those with immediate needs, Diane, Floyd, Lucy, Michelle, Lisa, Bernice, Wendy, Doug, Nolan, Joe, Dunstan, Margaret, Ipsita, Evelyn, Esther, Jason, Andrea, Brenda, Pat, Joe, Reeve, Beverly, Derek, Marie, Barry, Andy, Nigel, Linda, Doreen, Lila, Tatiana, Audrey, and Maida. We also pray for those with ongoing challenges, Dawn, Janice, Marjorie, May, Murray, Rosaline, Mark, Candace, Randy, Joan, Thomas, Clovis, Rosalind, Kathleen, Mike, Joan, Lionel, Monica, and Rajiv. Today we remember with love our parents, Lori and Veronica, by the Murray family. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may send the fire of the Holy Spirit upon his people, that we may bear faithful witness to his resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Remembering St. Ninian, St. John, St. Peter, and all the saints, we also remember those who battle COVID-19 in our prayers. Loving God, hope of the poor, and source of all health, look with compassion upon your creatures who suffer under the weight of this pandemic. Fill us with love towards our neighbor. Deliver us as we strive for the common good, and strengthen those who labor for our health. We ask this through the healer of your creation, Jesus Christ, our health and our salvation. Amen. God, our strong deliverer, when those charged with the urgent mediation of your healing power feel overwhelmed by the numbers of the suffering, uphold them in their fatigue and banish their despair. Let them see with your eyes, so they may know all their patients as precious. Give comfort and renew their energy and compassion for the sake of Jesus, in whom is our life and our hope. Amen. Loving God, we pray for this church community in this time of crisis. Deliver us from simply desiring to go back to normal, and give us grace instead to be open to the opportunities that your Spirit brings in this time of separation. Grant that we may come out of this crisis with open eyes, more fully available to the needs of those most vulnerable and those whose labor we have always depended on. Give us creative hearts to embrace and carry forward the news, the new ways we have found to connect with one another, and in your good time, bring us safely back together as a people, renewed in the knowledge of your faithfulness and abiding love, and strengthened for the work ahead. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. We pray for all those who have died due to COVID-19. Grant them eternal rest, O Lord, and make your light shine perpetually upon them. Finally, we pray for all three parishes. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, Receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry, they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, our strength and salvation, receive all we offer you this day, and grant that we who have confessed your name and received new life in baptism may live in the joy of the resurrection through Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise for this glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he destroyed death. By his rising to life again, he has won for us eternal life. Therefore, joining our voices with the whole company of heaven, we sing our joyful hymn of praise to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you've made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all, the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you've delivered us from evil, made us worthy to stand before you. In him you've brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he gave thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he gave thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. And in the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to the city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord, we died with you on the cross.
Now we are raised to new life.
We are buried in your tomb.
Now we share in your resurrection.
Live in us that we may live in you. The gifts of God for the whole family of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. God of life, bring to us the glory of the resurrection promise in this Easter sacrament. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the risen Lord. Amen. Glory to God,
whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you for being with us this morning. We hope that this Easter service has touched you and your family in a special way. I just have a few announcements to make, mostly thanks and appreciation. I want to thank our children and youth who contributed their creativity to our Easter display, actually our whole Holy Week and Easter display. That's very important to our life to include everyone. I also want to thank Gail and Lisa, who have done such an amazing job with the flowers. They are so beautiful, and it's so wonderful, even though we can't physically be in this space all together, we can see these beautiful arrangements. They have been working hard behind the scenes, as have all three congregations, to make certain that what you see in your church, in the church, is the representation of your love for God. I want to thank everyone who offered their services all through Holy Week, from all three congregations, contributing to our many experiences that have enriched our life. I also want to make a special thanks towards Jamie, who, at least in this location, has been absolutely critical to all of our technical work, and I know that the other congregations have benefited from his technical ability as well. And he also wrote the setting for the psalm today. So that's quite a wonderful gift to us all, that this was a unique piece of music offered to us, all three congregations, in this wonderful celebration of Easter. I know from the other congregations that there have been people helping with their own technology and experience, and I am very thankful for their ministry as well. It is wonderful to have so many people committed to the life and witness in Scarborough. Now, this coming week, we are going to take some time off, at least here, but starting on the 14th of April, we are going to have a midweek Eucharist at the Brimley Road location, where we will gather for communion, to have some Easter communion, with whomever is here, up to 10 people, so you need to pre-register. The communion we will be sharing has already been blessed this day, and so we will be doing a shortened version of the Eucharist. If you would like to join on the 14th, the 21st, or the 28th at 11 a.m. at the Brimley Road St. Peter's site, please call and register. Also, the clergy are available to do home communions, so if you would like communion at your home, please be in touch and we'll arrange a time for that. Remember, Easter is more than one day, and we will use Eastertide to share the communion we have blessed this day. Thank you.
The blessing of the glorious Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Heaven and heaven in
slain.